Now, I do have kiddos hanging out in the background because mom life, and so you might hear some noises as we do this. The math activity box. This comes in a cardboard box. It's the Good and the Beautiful curriculum on there. Has a list of the items included, which is awesome in case we end up misplacing some or have spilled it all over the floor. This tells me how many I need to find. It's a cute little suitcase look. This kit belongs to. And this box covers levels 1 and 2. So we have a little clock and the hands can move. Looks like, yep, they move independently. We have some two-sided counting chips. There's 20 in here. And then there's some game pawns and 2 10-sided dice. Here we have the mini wooden figures, and I'll show you what they all are. There's a sphere, a cube, a cylinder, a cone, a triangular pyramid, hexagonal prism, triangular prism, rectangular prism, and 2 hemispheres. Now, if you're trying to build this box yourself, you need to see what those look like. Then we have the 99 domino cards.
While I was editing, I realized that I did not capture a look at what these domino cards look like. So here's a quick view. They are tiny little cards. They're glossy, so they slide around nice and easy. If you're trying to build the box yourself, I would suggest just getting some dominoes that go up to 99s and working with that.
We have a measuring tape with the Good and the Beautiful logo, so we know this is the one that goes in the math box because we have a few of these. Here's the game instruction booklet. Let's do a quick flip through of that. This is a glossy paper. This is all shrink wrapped together, so let's see what's in here. This is like a, almost like a photo paper. It almost feels laminated. It's like a super high gloss, super soft, probably so that you can use dry erase marker on it really easily. Kiddo one wants to help me, so I'm gonna let her flip through these.
So it looks like there's the name of these work mat pages at the bottom. Looks like these are perforated to come apart. These ones feel perforated too. Looks like these are perforated too. And that's the end. There's just a cardboard piece on the back.
The way I'm going to store these is like I did with level K. I just have a binder that I put them in page protectors. And then I had the place value chart, which you'll see farther in the box. So these are the bags for all of these manipulatives. So we'll open these and look at these first. And again, kiddo one wants to help out, so I'm gonna let her flip through them.
So you'll just punch out these parts and then store them in these bags. What they call this is a chipboard. It's like a really stiff cardboard. These are the bags you'll put the chipboard pieces in. So these are the pockets for the place value chart that we will see later in this box. This is for the egg manipulatives, the tangram pieces, the seashell manipulatives, the marble manipulatives, and the fraction pieces. These are the numbered game cards. This is slightly glossy cardstock, and it's perforated. These are also perforated. These wipeout cards are probably for a game, and these are the math symbol cards. These are the base 10 cards. They're perforated in the same way as all the rest. And here's that place value chart. So this is where the pockets that were in this bag over here will go. Then you'll cut these pieces out and use them for the place value chart activities. It feels like a cardstock material. And that's everything in the box. Now we're gonna look at the planner for level one.
Here's some monthly stickers.
About me. Each page has this note. Do not complete this page until the course book instructs you to do so.
Hi, I'm Elaine from On the Same Page Together. We are a Christ-centered home of learning, and on this channel, we talk about all things family. I will have links to the curriculum and other related videos in the description box down below. While you're there, go ahead and give this video a thumbs up and leave me any questions or comments that you may have. Liking or commenting on my videos helps me reach other parents who are also looking for this curriculum. Thanks to my awesome friend, up next in this series will be Math Level 2, so subscribe and hit that notification bell to not miss when I upload it. Here's the playlist with all of the videos in this series, and here's a video that YouTube thinks you'll like. But if you haven't yet, check out the in-depth flip through of Math Level 1, where you will see every page in both course books. Just click right up here, and I'll see you over there.